Okay, in the previous video, what we were looking at the transformations on the parent function of absolute value. Actually, we looked at a whole bunch of different parent functions and saw what the a, the h, and the k did. So, you might be wondering, like, whenever I had you write down that equation y equals a times the absolute value of x minus h plus k, why did the h get the negative but a k got the positive sign? Okay, and remember whenever we did the transformations, the h was backwards. That if it was a -3, this actually meant to go to the right 3, and if it was a +3, that meant to go to the left 3. What? Totally confusing. But the k was in the same direction. If it was +3, it meant up 3, and so on. Well, the whole thing is because the k is on the wrong side of the equation. If we put it over there where it belongs with the y, then they're both exactly the opposite number. So let me look at this in terms of, let's say, the point-slope form. When I look at the point-slope form, that's the same kind of thing. If I had the point, for example, when I put in a point-slope form, if I have the point 3 comma 5, in this point-slope form, I would put y minus 5 equals the slope times x minus 3, right? And notice that both of them are negative, okay? Even though the actual points themselves are positive, okay? So here is that same kind of thing with actual numbers here. So if I look at the one with the arrow, I know that this 3 here is going to vertically scale all the y's by 3. I know that this negative 2 that's inside here is supposed to shift it to the right 2, and this positive 5 is supposed to shift it up 5. Okay, and again, this is just because these are backwards because the 5 is on the wrong side of the equation. If I put it over here on the second part where it belongs with y, then you can see that they both have the opposite sign. They both have the opposite sign. If that confuses you, don't worry about it. Here's an easier way to think of it. So take a look at this picture here. You can see that you got a boy, he's cheating. This guy has to be lying to his girlfriend, right? Okay, so what you just want to remember is that your exes always lie. Exes are the boys, they're always lying. The girl right there in the hat, she's probably telling the truth here. So let me just write an example here. Let's put it in red. Yep, looks fine. So y equals 3 times the absolute value of x minus 2 plus 5. Okay, so this negative 2, it's associated with the x. X's always lie, so instead of that going to the left 2, it's going to lie 2, it's actually going to go to the right 2. Okay? And the positive 5, it's associated with the y. The y's always tell the truth, that's going to go up 5. So the x's, that's a liar. The y's, they're telling the truth. Okay? That's an easy way for you to distinguish these two. So, let's put these things together and let's do transformations all together with the a, the h, and the k. So in general, the graph the absolute value functions has translations in it, and it has stretches or shrinks, and it has reflections all together. Okay? So I'm going to show you two different methods. The first one only works on absolute value parent functions, but it's probably the simpler way to do it. The second way that involves SRT transformations will work on any kind of parent function, any single one. Okay? So let's look at that first form. So let's say I have the equation y equals a times the absolute value of h plus k. The a, the h, and the k, they're just numbers. Whatever the numbers give it to us are given to us in the problem. Okay? I'm going to call this one the vertex method. I'm going to start with step number one. I'm going to plot that vertex h and k. Just remember, of course, the h here is going to lie to you. This is a liar, but the k there is going to tell the truth as to what the sign is and what direction it goes. So the hk gives us our vertex. Plot that as a point, okay? Now, step two, you're going to use the a value that's up front here. Use this a value as a slope. Okay? And that's going to plot one side of your graph. If it's 2, that means you're going to go up 2 and right 1. That's going to give you one side of the graph. In step 3, to get the other side, you're just going to use symmetry. You reflect that across you reflect it across so you can get the other side of that V shape. And then finally, step four, you're going to put it all together to make, connect the dots in that V shape. Okay, you only really need 3 points here. You might get a couple of more just so you can get a nice line on each side. So let's put these things together. Let's graph a couple of these. So we're going to graph number one together, and then I'm going to have number two you do by yourself. And I want to also be able to compare it to the parent function. I want you to be able to tell me, like, how is it different from the parent function? Okay, so let's take that number one there, where it says absolute value of x, y equals absolute value of x minus 2 plus 5. So whenever I go to graph this thing, my vertex is at the point 2, 5. That thing lies, that thing does not lie. Okay, so that's the first step. I'm going to find that vertex, I'm going to plot that as a point 2, comma 5, I'm going to put a dot. Okay, what is the a value that's right up front? This a value is just 1. It's not a slope because this isn't a line, but if like each half of it, like the right hand side of it, would have a slope of 1, which means I go up 1, right 1, up 1, right 1, and to reflect it across this kind of axis of symmetry, I go up one, left one for this V shape, up one, left one. And if I connect the dots in my V shape, there's my absolute value function. So the second part of this is, how does this compare to the parent function? Well, it's not stretched any. It doesn't get fatter or skinnier. It's not reflected. The only thing that happens is that this is translated 2 to the right, 2 to the right, remember, because it lies, and then up 5, up 5. All right, so I want you to take a moment on some graph paper, and I want you to try to do the same kind of thing on that second equation. Pause the video. All right, let's see how successful you were at graphing that thing. So here's my graph. I would first start by finding the vertex, and the vertex is negative 4, negative 2, because the 4 is lying to you, but the negative 2 is not. So I'll plot that as a point. There's my vertex point. And the a value, what I'm scaling it by, is negative 2/3. So I'm going to use that like a slope for the right side of the graph. I would go down 2 and right 3, down 2, right 3. Okay, in order to make the V shape, I also go down 2 and left 3, down 2, left 3, in order to make it symmetric, and then I make my V shape. To compare it to the parent function, that's what I have right down here. Notice I have an S, an R, and a T, and that's what we're going to do in the next video here. SRT transformation, scaling, reflecting, and translating it. I am translating I'm scaling all of the y values by 2/3. This is a vertical shrink. Okay. I'm also reflecting the parent function across the x-axis because it's pointing downwards instead of pointing upwards. And then finally, I am translating every single point to the left 4 and down 3. Okay.